Last class, we did the laws of chemical combinations. Now today we are doing the numericals based on these laws. The first law is law of conservation of mass. The question is, if we are taking 4.90 gram of KClO3, potassium chlorate, and heat it, it will give 1.92 gram of oxygen. And along with this, there will be a residue KCl. The weight of this KCl is 2.96 gram. Show that these results illustrate the law of conservation of mass. Now this law says the mass of reactants is always equal to the mass of the products. So read the statement carefully and find out the reactants and the products and write equation, chemical equation from that. It's clear, potassium chlorate is a reactant and on heating it is giving oxygen and KCl. So oxygen and KCl are the products. So this reaction is, we are taking potassium chlorate here and on heating it is giving oxygen plus residue, that is the KCl. Now the mass of the reactant is 4.90 grams. I'm writing under this reactant the mass of this reactant. And how much oxygen is there? 1.92 oxygen will form. And residue forming is 2.96 gram. So we know the mass of reactant and we know the mass of the product. According to law of conservation of mass, because we have to illustrate the law of conservation of mass, so we are using the law of conservation of mass. According to this, mass of reactants should always be equal to the mass of products. Now reactant is 4.90 gram and product is 1.92 plus 2.96. These are the products. This will come out to be equal to 4.88 gram. Approximately the mass of reactant is equal to the product. This little error which is there, how much error is coming? We call this as experimental error. 4.90 minus 4.88 is equal to 0.02 gram. This small error is called experimental error. While doing experiment only, there is some error in calculating the masses, or there is some wastage of the mass that is left in the container or it spills down like that. There can be an experimental error. So we'll say approximately these are equal. And hence this illustrates a law of conservation of mass. So like this we have to do the numericals of law of conservation of mass. Just take the mass of reactant and product and see these are coming out to be equal to each other. It will come out to be equal to each other. There can be a little error, which is experimental error. Law means it will be verified always. So this is the numerical for the law of conservation of mass. Now we are moving on to the next law, that is law of constant composition, or this is also known as law of definite proportion. So this law is law of constant composition. Numerical: 6.488 gram of lead combines with 1.002 gram of oxygen and forms lead peroxide. Mass of reactants is given and this is the product forming. There's another method also to form lead peroxide. It is produced by heating lead nitrate and it was found that percentage of oxygen second time is 13.38%. So what is law of constant composition? A compound is always made up of same elements. Compound here is lead peroxide. It's always made up of same elements Prepare this compound by any method, but it will always be made up of same elements, and the ratio of the masses of two elements will always be constant. So if we know the oxygen 13.38 by second method, in first method also the percentage of oxygen should be 13.38%. This is law of constant composition, that the masses of the two elements which are combining here, their ratio will always be same. If the mass ratio is same, that means the percentage will also be same. So now we have to find out the percentage of oxygen in the first case and see that in first case it is coming out to be equal to 13.38%. So now second time also is 13.38%. That means this will verify the law of constant composition. So our solution is to find out the percentage of oxygen, we need the mass of oxygen and we need the mass of the compound. So mass of lead peroxide is reactants, they will add up 6.488 plus 1.002. The mass of reactant is always equal to the mass of the product. Mass of reactant is always equal to mass of the product according to law of conservation of mass. So these two masses, lead and oxygen, will add and it will be equal to the mass of the lead peroxide. This is coming out to be 7.490 gram. This much we'll get. Now percentage of oxygen, this is equal to the mass of oxygen upon mass of lead peroxide into that of 100. Mass of oxygen is 1.002, mass of lead peroxide is 7.490 into 100. This is 13.38%. Now percentage of oxygen first time is also equal to that of the second case. That means this is illustrating the law of constant composition. So we'll write percentage of oxygen in PbO2 in first and second experiment is 13.38, that is identical. This illustrates the law of constant composition. So if the percentage comes out to be same of one element, that means percentage of second element will also be same, because that will be 100 minus the percentage of the first element. So if the percentage is coming out to be same of the two elements, that means their masses will also be the same. So this is the first numerical for the law of constant composition. Now one more numerical for law of constant composition. This is a statement for second numerical. Now here we are preparing copper oxide. See, one compound we are preparing, but there are three methods to prepare it. Different methods are there. By any method we prepare copper oxide, there will be copper and oxygen, and ratio of these elements by mass should be same. So that only we have to see. In all these three methods, are we getting the same percentage of copper and oxygen? If percentage of copper and oxygen comes out to be same by all three methods, that means this will illustrate the law of constant composition. So any method, will not see the method, we'll just see the masses of the elements copper and oxygen in all three cases. This is what we need. So solution for this numerical. In first experiment, what is given? 1.75 gram of copper, metal here is copper. It is dissolved in nitric acid, this method is done, and after that we are getting copper oxide. How much? 2.19 gram. So mass of compound is given and mass of copper is given. Can we find out the percentage of copper from this? In first experiment, percentage of copper is equal to mass of copper upon the mass of copper oxide into 100. Mass of copper is 1.75. Mass of copper oxide is 2.19 into 100. This will come out to be equal to 79.91%. Similarly, in second experiment, we find out the percentage of copper. Now, second case, see, 1.14 gram of metal is there. 1.14 gram of copper metal is there. Now, we are doing this whole method, and after that, we are getting 1.43 gram of copper oxide. Into 100, we'll get 79.92% of copper in the second experiment. Similarly, in third experiment also, we find out the percentage of copper. Third case, 1.45 gram of copper is here, and after doing this whole method, we are getting 1.83 gram of copper oxide. Into 100, 79.78%. So percentage of copper in copper oxide in all three experiments is approximately same. I told you if it is coming out a little different, that is experimental error. Hence, it illustrates the law of constant composition. So, law of constant composition, we are finding out the percentage of one element in all the cases given. If the percentage of that element every time comes out to be same, this will illustrate the law of constant composition. Now, after this, we are moving on to the next law, that is the law of multiple proportions. In the law of multiple proportion, this is a numerical statement, or the first numerical is carbon forms two oxides which contain 42.9% and 27.3% of carbon. Show that these figures illustrate the law of multiple proportion. Now, what is law of multiple proportion? This law says when two elements, like here, if we read this statement, the two elements we will get are carbon and oxygen. Two elements, they combine to form more than one compound. So carbon is found to form two oxides. These elements are forming two type of carbon oxides. And percentage of carbon is given in the two oxides. Show that these figures illustrate the law of multiple proportion. So what we'll do in these experiments is we'll write the element carbon and oxygen. Its first oxide, we'll just write first oxide because formulas are not mentioned in the statement. So just write first oxide and second oxide, the two oxides. The percentage of carbon in first oxide is 42.9% and in the second case is 27.3%. This is given. So what about the percentage of oxygen? Compound is just made up of two elements. If one element percentage is this, second element percentage will be 100 minus the first one, because total in percentage is always 100. So this will come out to be equal to 57.1%, and this is 100 minus 27.3 come out to be equal to 72.7%. So we know the percentage of carbon in the first and second oxide, and we also know the percentage of oxygen in the first and second case. Now, in the law of multiple proportion, one of the elements' mass is always same. So now, out of carbon and oxygen, we have to keep the mass of one of the elements same. Then only we'll come to know about the mass of the second element and its ratio. So for this, what we'll do is, in first oxide we are taking. Now fix the mass of any element. In first oxide we are taking, if we have oxygen 57.1 parts by mass, then carbon is how much? This is the oxygen. Oxygen is 57.1 parts by mass. Then carbon is equal to how much? If oxygen is this much, carbon will be 42.9 parts. And if oxygen we take one part, we are fixing oxygen one part. If we take this one part, then carbon will be, unitary method we are using, 42.9 upon 57.1. This much will be carbon. If oxygen in first case is one part. Similarly, in second case, how much is oxygen in second case? 72.7%. If oxygen is 72.7 parts by mass, then carbon in second case is how much? 27.3 parts. But if we take oxygen as one part, we are fixing, see, oxygen we have fixed in the two compounds one part, then carbon is 27.3 upon 72.7 parts. So if one of the element amount is same, the other element amount, this amount will be a simple multiple ratio. So write these two in a ratio form, that ratio will come out to be a simple multiple ratio. So we'll say mass of carbon combining with fixed mass of oxygen, and that mass how much we are taking? 1. Mass of carbon combining with fixed mass of oxygen, one part, that is one part, in two oxides is, in these two oxides, when one part oxygen we are taking, how much carbon we will have? This much. So this we are writing is 42.9 upon 57.1 is 227.3 upon 72.7. We have written the ratio of the carbon element in two compounds. After solving this, we will get, when we divide it, we get 0.751, and this will get 0.376. Now divide this and this both with the 0.376 with a smaller value, and this will come out to be 2:1. So this ratio is a simple multiple ratio. Hence, the law of multiple proportion is illustrated. So for law of multiple proportion, this is a method that we have to follow. We need the masses of the two elements in a compound. For law of definite proportion, we have to calculate the percentage of one element in a compound. For law of multiple proportion, we need the masses of the elements in the compounds. And then we have to fix one element amount every time, and the second element amount that we'll get, that we write in a ratio form. That ratio will come out to be a simple multiple ratio. So this is the law of multiple proportion, first numerical. Now coming to the second numerical of law of multiple proportion. This is a statement for second numerical. Now we have two oxides of certain metal. Metal oxides are there, and we are heating them in hydrogen. So when oxide of metal, like I'm writing it here, if we take exposed metal oxide and heat it with hydrogen, we know we'll get metal, and along with that what we'll get is a water. So two different oxides of metals we are heating in hydrogen. Separately we are heating in hydrogen, and what we get every time? Water. The water produced in each case was collected. This water that we will get by heating the two oxides of metal, this we will collect. If we take 2 grams of each oxide, the metal oxide, how much we are taking every time? 2 grams. It gave first time this much amount of water and second time this much amount of water. Show that these results establish the law of multiple proportion. Now, what we have to do in these numericals, like I told you, we need the mass of the elements to solve a numerical. So which elements are here in a compound? 2 oxides of certain metal. That means elements are metal and oxygen. So in both these metal oxides, we need the mass of metal and oxygen. And here, mass of metal oxide is given and mass of water is given. So mass of metal and oxygen is not given. How we'll calculate it? From water, we can calculate the mass of oxygen. From water, we can calculate the mass of oxygen. How we can calculate the mass of oxygen from water? We know gram molecular mass of water is, atomic mass of hydrogen is 1 into 2 plus 16. It's 18 grams. The molar mass of water is 18 grams. In this 18 grams of water, how much is oxygen? 16 grams. If we take 18 grams of water, then oxygen in that is equal to 16 grams. And how much water we have in the first case? 0.2517 grams. So if we take this much amount of water, then in that how much oxygen will be there? Again, unitary method, 16 by 18 into 0.2517 gram. We will get this as 0.2237 gram. So we have got the mass of oxygen in the first oxide. So this is the first metal oxide. We have calculated the mass of oxygen. Similarly, in second metal oxide, 18 gram of water has how much oxygen? Again, 16 gram. 18 gram of water will always have 16 gram of oxygen. But how much water we have second time? 0.4526 gram. So if we take 0.4526 gram of water, how much oxygen will be there? 16 by 18 into 0.526 gram. This will come out to be equal to 0.4023 gram. So we have got the mass of oxygen in the first and in the second metal oxide. And now we need the mass of metal. How we can calculate that? We know the mass of the compound. From compound, if we subtract the mass of oxygen, rest will be the mass of the metal. So here, first oxide, first metal oxide, and next is second metal oxide. And these have elements metal and oxygen. Now, oxygen in first case we have calculated is 0.2237 grams. And in second case, oxygen is 0.4023 gram. So how much is metal? Metal oxide is 2 gram. So that means metal is 2 minus 0.2237 gram. And here the metal is 2 minus 0.4023 gram. Compound minus the mass of oxygen element. Difference will give us the mass of the metal. So this one will be equal to 1.7763 gram. In this case, this will come out to be equal to 1.5977 gram. So now to solve these numericals, like I said, we need the mass of the elements in the compound. We have got both these elements' masses. Now, next what we have to do is fix the mass of any one of the elements, metal or oxygen, and find out the mass of the second element every time and write that mass in a ratio form. That ratio will be a simple multiple ratio. So next, after this, what we have to do is see, now fix one of the element masses here. Mass of oxygen and metal is here. Metal, how much we are taking is 1.7763 gram of metal. This is the first case. Combines with oxygen. This much amount of metal combines with this much amount of oxygen. That is 0.2237 gram. And if we take metal as 1 gram, how much oxygen will be there? 0.2237 upon 1.7763. This much is the mass of the oxygen. Now come to second case. How much metal we have second time? 1.5977 gram of metal combines with oxygen is equal to how much oxygen we have second time is 0.4023 gram. Now if we take metal as 1 gram, then we are getting oxygen as this much amount. So see, if the mass of one of the elements, metal, in both the cases is 1 gram. If mass of one of the element is the same, then the second element mass, this mass of second element will always be a simple multiple ratio in the compounds of these elements. So now, the mass ratio of oxygen in the two cases is, oxygen ratio is 0.2237 upon 1.7763 is to 0.4023 upon 1.5977. This much we will get. Now when we compare these ratios after dividing, we will get this as 1:2. Divide these, like I told you in the previous numerical, then with the smaller value we have to divide both these values, it will change to whole number 1:2. Since this is a simple ratio, so this illustrates the law of multiple proportion. So in the law of multiple proportion, first we need to get the mass of the elements which are mentioned in the compound. Like here, compound is metal oxide. So we need the mass of metal and oxygen. So first we will get that thing, this table we need. And after this thing, fix the mass of any one of the elements and find out of the other in all the cases. One element mass is same, the other one, this will write in a ratio form. This ratio will come out to be a simple multiple ratio. So this is a numerical for the law of multiple proportion. So three laws numericals we have covered up today: law of conservation of mass, law of constant proportion, and law of multiple proportion.